had some good days. I've had some hills to climb. I've had some weary days. And some sleepless nights. But when I look around, yeah, I think things over. All of my good days outweigh my bad days. Sometimes the clouds hang low. I can hardly see the road. I ask the question, Lord, Lord, why so much pain? But He knows what's best for me. Although my weary eyes, they can't see. So I'll just say, thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah, hallelujah. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. I won't complain. I've had some good days. I've had some bad days. I've had some hills to climb. Hallelujah. But I won't complain. God's not through with me yet. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. God bless you out there. Amen. You're listening to RMCGospel.com. This is your pastor, Warren J. Smith, also known as the Gospel Rider. Amen. Riding through the city of Los Angeles. Amen. Telling folk how good God is. Hallelujah. But that's one thing we need to know. Amen. You just can't come in any old kind of way. Praise the Lord. The Bible lets us know we need to be followers of God as dear children. Hallelujah. And walk in love as Christ also had loved us. Watch what the word say. And He has given Himself for us an offering, a sacrifice for a sweet smelling Savior. Hallelujah. Oh yes, but there's so much mess going on out there. Oh yes, you got fornicators, amen, and you got all uncleanness and covetousness. Things, amen, that the world approve of, but God is not endorsing any of that. Hallelujah. So it is entirely up to you. Seek the Lord now while He may be found. Call upon Him while He is yet near. Time is winding up, amen. Handwriting is on the wall, praise God, hallelujah. And God's been good to you, hallelujah. Oh, yes, amen. But we need to have a certain condition, amen, a certain way, amen, that we need to stand up with our precedent for the Lord, amen. That's a condition we call of salvation, amen. And right now, amen, let's go to one of my YouTube clips, amen, and see what we're talking about on conditions of salvation, amen. Hallelujah.
As you got the Lord,
amen,
on your side, He is more for you than the whole world is against you. Isn't that right?
Amen.
Right. If you call yourself a child of God, then act like one.
Amen.
Huh? Amen. Your source is in the Lord.
Amen.
He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall
abide
under
the shadow of the Almighty.
Trust in the Lord with all thine heart and lean not into thy own understanding.
All thy way.
He shall what?
Acknowledge Him. And He shall direct that path.
Ooh, that's bread from heaven.
Amen.
Ah, that food for the soul for the day. That food for the soul, for the spirit. If God be for you, can't nobody be against you.
Amen.
Delight yourself also in the Lord. In the Lord. In the Lord. And he will give you the desires. Just by living for Christ, living for God, just by letting the light shine, just by being a bona fide saint of God. What that mean? That means you're living your life to please God. Amen. That don't mean you're so holier than thou. Let's straighten that out right now. Nah, all we like sheep have went astray.
Yes. We're all sheep of his pasture.
And he said, my sheep know my voice. And a stranger,
they will not
follow. So you see folks doing a whole lot of things and going on board by the thousands, by the hundreds of thousands. And you look at them, well, it looks like they're saints. They're singing. Well, he preaching. My God.
Yes, yes, yes. You can't just go any kind of way, amen. You're adopted into the family of God. You are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. Hallelujah. Peculiar people. Hallelujah. And you know, God chose you. Hallelujah. He brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Amen. See, you may be going through whatever you're going through, amen, but God always have the last say. You know, the Bible teaches us that if we just trust in the Lord with all of our heart, hallelujah, and lean not into our own understanding, but just acknowledge him in all our ways, hallelujah, he will direct our path. Hallelujah. I want you to know tonight, if God be for you, can nobody be against you. Hallelujah. It's up to you. And you, at the sound of my voice, amen. Those that see me, amen, all over the world, amen, you got to make a decision. The Bible tells us, choose this day who you going to serve. The Bible says no man can serve two masters. And Satan, the lion wonder, he come to kill, to steal, and to destroy. But Jesus came that you might have life and have it more abundantly. Hallelujah. And I'm going to talk a little bit, amen. I want to go to my YouTube clip about the bread of life, amen. And we're going to see some more about how good God is, amen, and what is God to us, amen. So let's go to this video.
Then said they unto him, what shall we do that we might work the works of God? And watch Jesus. You know, Jesus didn't have no college degree. You know, he didn't go to college. Look what he said. This is the work of God, that ye believe on him who had sin. He had sins. So what is the work of God? Believe on him. Who's him?
Jesus.
Whom he had sent. But he's still yet talking to them. And I guess he's talking in the seventh person here. Watch this now. They said therefore unto him, what sign showest thou? No. What sign showest thou then that we may see and believe thee? See, now you want proof. Now you want proof. But the proof is always in the pudding. Look what Jesus tells them. Our fathers did eat manna in the deserts. As it is written, he gave them bread from heaven to eat. Then said Jesus unto them, they talking about what their fathers did back in the day. Jesus said unto them, watch this now. Verily, verily, I say unto you, Moses gave you not that bread from heaven. He gave you bread, but not that bread from heaven. Huh? And you did eat, and you did get full. But you're going to need something more than the food that I give you. You're going to need a whole lot more than that.
Yeah.
The inner man, which is the Spirit of God, that man got to be fed. Huh? Hallelujah. Watch this now. Glory to God. But my Father giveth you the true bread from heaven. For the bread of God is he which come down from heaven and giveth life unto the world.
Yeah.
Then said they unto him, Lord, evermore give us this bread. Lord, forevermore give us this bread. And Jesus said unto them, I am the bread.
Yeah.
He that cometh to me shall what? Never hunger. And he that believeth on me shall what?
Never
thirst. Is that right? So you see how important it is?
Oh, man.
Yes, yes, hallelujah. That's why we not only do we have the bread of life, amen. God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in the time of trouble. If it ever was a time you need to know the Lord, now is that time. Today is the day of salvation. I just submit to you, amen, as I tell all the church folks and anybody come to the sound of my ear, every time I get to a microphone, amen, trust God and pastors, missionaries, whoever you are, vessels of the Lord, tell God's people the truth. Stop all this monopoly and all this. It ain't about you. Hallelujah. It's about the people of God having the knowledge of God through the ministers of the gospel. Hallelujah. There's only one way. And Jesus declared himself, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man goeth to the Father but by me. Hallelujah. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth be removed, though the mountains be carried into the midst of the sea, though the waters thereof roar and be troubled. Hallelujah. You ain't got to worry because you belong to God. Hallelujah. God cares for you. God loves you. God is concerned for you. Hallelujah. There is no other name given among men under heaven whereby we must be saved. For the Bible says, at the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow, and every tongue, watch this now, must confess that Jesus is Lord. Not only that, he's Lord of lords. He's the Alpha and Omega. He's the beginning and the end. He's the first and the last. And even on top of that, he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. Nobody can say it plainer than my sister Mahalia. Hallelujah. As she go about and we go on this break, amen, go and tell it on the mountain. Hallelujah. Sister Mahalia, talk to us right now. Hallelujah. Telling us what to do. Go tell it on the mountain. Hallelujah.
Go tell it on the mountain. Over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain. But Jesus Christ is born. In the Jesus Christ were born.
Yes, 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 hallelujah. That's what we got to do. Be about our Father's business. Tell it, amen. They call me the gospel rider, amen. And that's what the instrument that I use is the motorcycle riding through the alleys, highways, byways, amen. I mean, just telling folk how good God is. And you know, it's so effective when you tell somebody you ain't by yourself. Hallelujah. You'd be surprised how that just lifts a homeless person up or a gangbanger to think he had to just belong to a gang. Hallelujah. Oh, God. God cares for all of us. The Bible say the earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof, the world, and they that dwell therein. Hallelujah. I'm here to tell you we serve a good God. No respect of person. Yes, dear hearts. God loves you, and God is concerned for you. Amen. Hallelujah. Oh, my God. Hallelujah. What a mighty God we serve. Angels bow before him. Heaven and earth adore him. Hallelujah. God's got your back, and it don't matter what you go through. God's going to have the last say. So it's entirely up to you. Hallelujah. I don't have a heaven or hell to put nobody in. Nor do I claim to do. Hallelujah. I thank God for a way to get to God's people, because what God did for me, I'm telling it to everybody. Amen. I'm telling it on the radio. Amen. I'm on KTYM 845 on Tuesday nights. Hallelujah. I'm telling it over here at rmcgospel.com. Amen. I'm telling it also on stacksofgold. Amen.com. Amen. Every opportunity. Hallelujah. I'm telling folks about God. Hallelujah. How God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Hallelujah. And I want you to know this. You ain't got to be scared of anything. Amen. Let's go to another YouTube clip of Fret Not Thyself. Amen. And see what God got to say about this thing. Amen. See, I need some backup. And here's his backup. Hallelujah.
And hear me, ladies, and I will give you rest. Isn't God good? Hallelujah. And I always mention the fact about it. He loves everybody. It ain't about color, how rich you is. That ain't got nothing to do with it. God loves everybody, and we all belong to him. So fret not thyself because of evildoers, neither be thy envious against the workers of iniquity. Do that you know how to do to please God. For the Bible tells us, if God be for you, who can be against you? Y'all see how precious we are? You think I'm going to put God on the back burner for something else? Oh, my God. No, no, you got to take the back seat.
All right.
God should be first in your life. Didn't I say, trust in the Lord in all thy ways? Acknowledge him, and he'll direct our path. So we need to keep trusting God. You know, God sent a message of trust, a reminder to us, the church, here over and over and over. Trust God, trust God, trust God, trust God. Then we just read it just now, 2 minutes. It said, trust in the Lord and what? Do good. So shall thou dwell in the land, and verily thou shalt be fed. Then it also says what? Delight thyself also. Trust is one thing, but while you're trusting, delight thyself also. Huh?
Trust and obey.
And obey him. Delight thyself also in the Lord, and what does it say?
He shall give thee desire.
Oh, my God. You hear that? Man, now that is something. Hallelujah. Delight thyself. Now see, a lot of folks just trust, but they don't delight itself. Delight means, you know, live your life to please God. You know, do something to somebody just because you love God. Not because they're doing something, or not because you're going to get something out of it.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. One of my granddaughters asked me last night, say, "Ooh, Grandpa, you get paid for this, you get paid for that." I said, "I don't get paid for nothing. No, I love doing what I do for the Lord."
All right.
Hallelujah. And reason why I love it, I didn't tell you like this, but I'll tell you now, amen. Reason why I love it, because God has brought me out of darkness.
All right.
God has opened my eyes.
Hey.
Hallelujah. Oh, it's such a pleasure and a privilege Oh, you always have the will. Praise the Lord.
Yes, hallelujah. Yes, yes, yes. I got all these clips on YouTube. Amen. You can get me there, Pastor Warren J. Smith at YouTube, or Google me, Pastor Warren J. Smith, and then they all come up. You can get me on Tuesday night, amen, on a radio, KTYM, radio.com, amen. I'm there, amen. You can get me on Stacks of Gold, hallelujah. God has opened up avenues everywhere, amen, where I can have an opportunity to tell you about God, hallelujah. The Bible says the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord, hallelujah, hallelujah. And he delighted in his way. Now watch this. Though he fall, he shall not be utterly cast down, for the Lord upholdeth him with his hand. See how good God is? Hallelujah. Dear hearts, God loves you. God cares for you. And God's concerned for you. Your sickness, give it to God. Amen. Your bankruptcy, give it to God. Amen. There is nothing that you're going through that God can't handle. It's up to you. But you got to make that decision yourself. I can't do it. The Bible says it is appointed unto man once to die. After that, the judgment. Amen. So I can't preach you into heaven. But it's totally up to you. Hallelujah. Oh, yes. Jesus suffered, bled, and died for you. And we're saved by what? Grace. For by grace are we saved through faith. It is the gift of God. Because God loves you. Not of your works. Not of works, lest any man should boast. So Mr. Big Stuff, come off your high horse, thinking that you're going to buy your way into heaven. I got news for you. When you die, you're going to meet God. Oh, yes. Hallelujah. When you die, you're going to meet God. Hallelujah. Because God, as always, even now, in absolute, complete control. Hallelujah. That's why I say, go tell it on the mountain. Hallelujah. Sister Mahalia, she puts it real good. Amen. So I'm going to sign off with just letting Sister Mahalia just take us on out of here. But go tell it on the mountain. Come on, sister. Bring it on. Hallelujah.
Go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born everybody.
By the way, what I want to remind you of, amen, as we go on with this, according to the word of God, there's so many spirits out there. The Bible says, beloved, believe not every spirit. I don't want to leave you without letting you thinking that every time somebody says something, that God is in it. The Bible says, beloved, believe not every spirit, but try the spirit and see whether it is of God. Because many false spirits, false prophets are going out into the world and deceiving many folks. And the Bible tells us that people perish for the lack of knowledge. Hallelujah. But there is therefore now no condemnation to them that are in Christ. Hallelujah. I submit to you tonight that the safest place to be is in the arm of God. Hallelujah. The Psalms 91, see, he that what? Dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. No, I ain't no poet. I ain't making this up. That's the word. He that dwell in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. Hey, hallelujah. No respect of person. The earth is the Lord's, the fullness thereof the world. So wherever you are, hallelujah, God is concerned for you. Hallelujah. Bible say, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. Can you imagine the conversation going on back then? Let us make man in our image. Hallelujah. Word was with God, and the Word was God. But because God loved you so much, the Word became flesh and died. Now it's on you. I'm going to let Sister Mahalia bring it on out. Sister Mahalia, let us go and tell them about it now. Hallelujah. Take that to the bank. God bless you.
Thank you. Jesus Christ is born. Everybody, yeah, go tell it on the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain, but Jesus Christ is born. The shepherd kept the watching over their wandering flock.
Every Tuesday evening at 6:30, I'll be at rmcgospel.com. Every Tuesday evening, or rather Tuesday night, I'll be at KTYM 845. That's LA time, 845. Both of these are LA times. Amen. And you can reach me. And Stacks of Gold, 24 hours a day. Amen. They're always slipping in, back and forth. You may hear me four or five times, amen. But I'm always giving you what thus said the Lord. See, this is what it's all about. It ain't what I say. It's what the Bible say. Hallelujah. And don't forget, you belong to God. Because in his hands, he got the whole world. Hallelujah. God bless you, and I love you.
He's got the whole. Religion was a thing money could buy.